I thank God for being for blessing me. I called to occasion like this. And I've heard a lot about Mr. and Mrs. Sandles through her kids. And by meeting the family, I know you could tell that they were Christian red people and good people to know. So it's not that I don't have a family of my own, she don't have a family of her own. It's just that you know good people when you meet them and you be glad to be in their presence. And also, Mr. and Mrs. Coleman, I met them through their daughter by being friends with her daughter also, and they are still good people to know. I just say I thank God for letting us be able to come now. Thank you. Thank you.
Ray is telling me to be quiet, but I'm not. So we were in Richmond, and we were down there. They were planning this occasion, and they were saying that we were welcome to come. I had no idea that we were going to make it, but as I told her on the phone, when you have God in your plan,
it's all right.
When you put God first,
that's right.
It always will work out.
Yeah.
As my husband said, it's not that we both don't have parents and a family. I'm in a family of 14. There's 7 girls and 7 boys in my family. But it's just always good to be in the presence of good people. Mr. and Ms. Sanders, this is my first time meeting you. You have a wonderful family. I love you. And so I called you guys my Texas parents. Also, Mr. and Ms. Coleman. They are my Texas parents. So I have two sets of parents here. Thank you.
I would like to introduce my wife, who also sings, and will honor us with the song, Wheel Man.
Oh,
May I say at this time, I'm sure that you know that at this time, many people here would like to have something to say. It is a time that I know that a lot of people would like to have something to say. They have been asked of us, even in the beginning of the program, how long would the program be? Some of our talks were lengthy, so forth. I want to let you know that if someone here has something to say, if they would say it, not make it very lengthy, because they didn't say it. People would like to go as soon as they can. So that we're going to leave a small space. If someone just like to just have a word, just like to say.
I'm saying,
another thing that I'm thankful for my brothers, they're all really
Yeah. I'm the oldest man in this guy's house. I've been with Bertha Sandles and his wife for quite a few years. I met Bertha Sandles annoying me, and I've been seeing him walking around, and, but I didn't know about him. He found an application in for the lawyer one night, and those favorite said it was Marshall, said, oh, I got an application. I said, who did it? He says, hey, son.
I'm put the hat on the stalk and they lay down on the back. We know what we would have said for Sunderland. And we had blow the stalk there and said, "Go to my son." Sunderland, that's me. So we would get a bird. So I just have to give him credit. Your children is good. They will hurt some things that are not in my life. Every time I see them, I call them my children. I don't care what you say, but they're really good. And they're one of them. You know, when you have that family tied up, they mean something. So I think that's what Dick and Sam put the family down. I do it now. That's what holds you together. The lady said, "Well, I'll go right here." I believe in that. When you put God first, you can't beat that nowhere.
Kids call them. They, as long as I can remember, I think I was, four, when I started listening to Big Mama humming. She used to hum every time she cooked biscuits. And she'd go out and call the cow, you know, Sarah, you know, all those good things, and churning butter and all that stuff. But one thing nobody ever thought of is out of those nine boys, every one of them went to service, and with prayer, all of them came back. And I think that's God's ways of preserving a God-fearing family. And I want to thank God for you and everybody that is closely associated with the family. May God bless each and every one of you.
Glad to be here and glad to share this public service with you. Thank you. Just one thing. I wanted to. Daddy only has one brother here. Like the band, they just said that. They said it here.
Yeah.
I want him to say something. I think Mama has a nephew. Chuck, would you and Mary come in, please? You know that Rusty Lum's nephew. As a matter of fact, I didn't even know he was back there. And most of my brothers don't even know him. But I would certainly want him to reflect after like a band and say what he's going to say. But I think we must have something for Michael Band. I want you to say something too.
I'm just glad to be here tonight with my brother and sister. So I think enough been said, and I don't have much to say. So I'll tell this, like, Reverend told us, he said, everybody here wants to see Christ to hold up the hand. So they all held up their hand for what to do. So he said, well, I threw up my hand because I thought you were trying to get a load for the night.
Person that was like, began, she too touched all of our lives in the classroom. And we often call her Mrs. Cotton. She finally got married, Mrs. Foster. I was really jealous of her husband when he was married. But Mrs. Foster, we would just love to hear from you.
Thank you, Joe.
Sort of like Mrs. Foster, I just wondered when were they going to let me say something. However, I was going to be very obedient and sit quietly and still, but I was going to certainly have to talk to them about it later. When I, the last one to go to that community, Prairie Hill, and the two honorees up there now made me so welcome. I was welcome because they were so Christian-like, and their children were the same way. You didn't have this problem with them in the schoolroom that you have now, and you know why by now. I must say that I have enjoyed to the others being here. I was with them last year, but I must say that I have certainly enjoyed, and I want to thank you for even thinking enough of me to send me an invitation to be here. Your Christian attitude from your parents did something to me the years that I was at Prairie Hill. Mr. Sanders could say something to me and it sounded just like my dad. Mrs. Sandles would cook and say, carry this down there and give it to her, you know. And it didn't make any difference. She said, please don't span the rock. You whip, don't send him back here whipping. Let me say that I can see from some of you and from all of you that you certainly grew up in that Christian home and you let it stay with you. Carry it with you now. And your children, you had standing here, do the same thing for them as your parents did for you. And you will see where you will be blessed just like your parents. And they will honor you.
And what we could do for mom and dad, many thoughts came to us. We didn't really know what to do. So we sit down and we decided that we would do something as a unit, as a group, as a family. And in presenting this plaque to my mom and my dad, there were three verses from the Bible that stood out in my mind. Ecclesiastes, third chapter, first verse, which reads as thus: to everything there is a season and a time for every purpose under the heaven. Proverbs 22:6, which reads: train up a child in the way in which he should go, and when he is old, he will never depart from it. Exodus, the 20th chapter and the 12th verse, states: honor thy father and thy mother, and thy days may be long upon the land with the Lord thy God. Mom and dad, this is the time, you raised us well, and you're here, John. And I'd like all the brothers, and our wives, and all the immediate family, nieces, nephews, and what have you, to come up here and help me present this plaque. This plaque reads, congratulations to Mom and Dad on your 60th wedding anniversary. All your
thank you. shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the calm, still waters, and He restores my soul, whatever I need. He's right there, and I know I can cast all of my burden on Him, for He cares. I know that He cares. Ooh,
the Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd.
My shepherd,
the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
The Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
I shall not want.
The Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
I shall not want. Yea, though I walk
through the valley
of the shadow.
Thank you. is jealous for me. Love's like a hurricane, I am a tree, bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I'm unaware of these afflictions, eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. Oh, how he loves us all. Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us all. Oh, how he loves us all. Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us all. We are his portion, and he is our prize, drawn to redemption by the grace in his eyes. His grace is an ocean, then we're all sinking, and then heaven meets earth like a sloppy wet kiss, and my heart turns inside. you're good.
You're good.